In this video, I will show you how to use Synopsys Custom Compiler and Keysight ADS on a common database. For this, we'll use a 28 GHz millimeter wave low noise amplifier designed with a Global Foundries 22FDX IPDK. One key aspect when using different platforms is to maintain the traceability of the database to avoid data loss, which is frequent when importing and exporting designs. Both ADS and Custom Compiler are currently opened and pointing to the same database. If I open the layout in Custom Compiler, you can see that ADS indicates it is read-only, as already checked out by Custom Compiler. So now, let's make a change in the database inside Custom Compiler by editing one inductor inner diameter from 30 micron to 50 micron and save the change. If we reopen the layout inside ADS, you can check that the cell has been updated accordingly. No export or anything like this, it's the same open access database and therefore instantly updated. Now let's proceed the other way around and start by undoing inside ADS the layout change done in Custom Compiler, reverting the inductor back to the initial design value. Equally, we can do the same on the schematic side by changing another parameter inside ADS and, as an example, add a text note to notify the change. That could be useful to give guidelines to the layout team about one specific net parameter that should be handled with more care for RF reasons. Going back to Custom Compiler, we can spot the layout change done in ADS is effective, and it is also true for the schematic part. We can undo the change here to get back to the initial values. As you can see, this is also undone inside ADS. As a summary, using IPDKs, you can easily switch between ADS and Custom Compiler. You can edit in your platform of choice with confidence while securing the design database traceability. Thanks for watching.